from Mumbai with an MBA from USA. He is currently at Mellon University, Pittsburgh, USA. He undertook management training with ICI in UK and computer training with IBM and Union Carbide. And sir, he took an early retirement to devote himself to management, education and training. Tenneke is a popular lecturer, trainer and writer on management topics, and his many managerial lectures on audio cassettes are used by over 1,000 organizations. So in this book, he is providing some social problems that commonly face managers. And first, we are going to discuss about the concept of managerial effectiveness. Functions of management. Management is a generic function which defines the basic terms such as the functions of management includes: it determines the mission of the organization, guides the organization, it gives direction to the organization, it manages, it sets objectives and organizes resources, and it tries to get maximum output from the least possible inputs. Mission. So it is the most important task of every manager to determine the mission of the organization. So in order to determine the mission of the organization, the manager must think through the potential of the organization and determine how much he can achieve. And this mission has to be evaluated routinely, because he should understand that whether in the changing environment, this mission is still valid, is still relevant. Otherwise, the organization will be producing a product that is no longer relevant. Social impact. No organization is ending itself or existing itself. Each one is an organ of the society and exists for the sake of the society. So the manager, the social effectiveness of the manager is determined by his contribution to the society through his organization. Satisfy honor logic. Honor logic refers to the expectations of the owner from his enterprise. So the managers must be the needs of the owner, satisfy the owners. Otherwise, they have to face an angry shareholder despite of the decent performance. Then team building with subordinates, sense of alertness. So any effective organization, if somebody notes that some opportunity is going lost or something wrong is happening, he knows that there is somebody whom he can approach and some action will be taken. This is the important characteristics of an effective organization. But on the other hand, if it is an ineffective organization, nobody cares about what is happening in the organization. They will not be bothered about what is happening there. So malpractices and mistakes will be regular and not responsible for them. So in that sense, in an ineffective organization, the top manager will be the last to know what is happening in the organization. Concerns for subordinates. In an effective organization, the manager will be concerned about the potential of his employees, subordinates. He counsels them to develop themselves. He also keeps a watch to find suitable prospects in the organization that he can give to his subordinates. So consequently, the subordinates will concentrate more on job, so they can produce more. But in an ineffective organization, the managers will not be careful about their subordinates. The boss is not at all worried about the potential or the development of the subordinates. He will not lift his finger to help his subordinates in his progress. So the subordinates will not concentrate more on work. So it will produce less. They will produce less of him. Team building with boss and colleagues, managing the boss. So in an organization, no work is done in isolation. Everything is teamwork only. So the managing the boss means, so the boss may not be able to increase or decrease the status of an employee, but he can have a lot of influence in enhancing or decreasing the stature of his subordinates, that is, ability to influence the people at all levels. So, if the manager demonstrates his subordinate, demonstrates that he values his subordinates, it will increase the stature of the subordinates. On the other hand, if the manager humiliates his subordinate, the stature will be reduced. Managing insecurity. If the boss is insecure, he takes every opportunity to criticize the man, criticize the subordinates and put him in his place. So it will affect the less performance by the subordinates. In order to manage the insecurity of the boss, the subordinate must demonstrate his loyalty to the manager. So keeping the boss informed about the developments that the subordinates comes to know of, which might be of interest to the boss, is one way of demonstrating his loyalty to the boss. Then helping the boss to repair the damages that might have been caused because of his mistakes only. Then managing ego. Every human being has an ego. So manager will also be having an ego. So if the ego is affected at home, if the ego is hurt, the relations will be affected adversely. So, subtle pampering of the necessary in order to create a positive relationship in the organization. Sharing the credit. It creates a world of difference if we share the credit with our subordinates. They will have a positive reaction that we value their points, their cooperation. So, leadership in management. Characteristics of a management leader. So the main characteristics of a management leader is authority. That is not because of his status, but because of his stature, that is, influence his people at all levels. The other is his having clear vision about what should be achieved in the future. Charisma. So it is an important aspect of a leader, because it is the level of trust and devotion, trust and dedication that the subordinates or the followers is having towards his leader. So the one of the important characteristics of this leader is that they will never be tired. They will always be having that energy level. If the entire organization is tired, they will continue. The Superman. So as the name indicates, superior person. He is having his own ethics that might be different from others and can stand for his own ethics. The hero. So the hero is having ethics as that of save of the society, but for him, his ethics are more important. His ethics are superior than anything. He stick to his principles and he will make any sacrifices for his principles, that he will sacrifice his job, position, status, anything for his principles or ethics. So this book in the world of corporate managers is for managers at all levels, from management trainees to managing directors. It contains solutions to the common problems that are faced by the managers, and diverse situations have been examined and ways to tackle them have been secondly worked out. So the book is characterized by his wit and humor, accentuated by the cartoon of the legendary architectman, is eminently readable by all present and potential practitioners